very important in your real life. So now I will talk about triage. What is triage? Triage is used during occur of a massive accident. So when there's a lot of casualty, then you don't know which casualty you have to treat first. So there is a rules called triage. You can apply during there is a lot of casualty, like tsunami or what. Okay, first there are four categories of the triage. The first one is the red one, which is immediate, the yellow, green, and the black. The black one is the worst condition. That means the casualties had no pulse and no breathing. The casualty is dead. So the immediate, what is the red category of the casualty? Red category of the casualty when there's occur of the massive hemorrhage, like hemorrhage through the femur, internal bleeding. And then the second one is the yellow one. The yellow one is the occur of the open fracture at the femur. But if you not treat the casualty for 20 to 30 minutes, the casualty may proceed into the red category, which can cause life threatening. So the third category is the green one. This one is the most lightest injured casualty. So the casualty usually can move him or herself. Then the black one, as I mentioned before, we cannot do anything to the patient, to the casualty. Okay, so now I will talk about the primary survey. After you doing the triage, so you can proceed to the next step, that is primary survey. So primary survey, there is one principle, that is DRABC. D is stand for danger, check for danger, and then if that, the place is safe, so you can proceed to respond, you can check for the response, you can ask, sir, may I check for, sir, can you hear me? Okay, so A is airway, you can open the airway by using the head, tail, chin, lift method, and then you can proceed to breathing, check for the casualty's breathing and circulation. If the casualty does not have breathing and pulse, then you can start for CPR. So while doing the CPR, you can get help from the public to get an AED for you, because AED can use to restore the normal heart rhythm of the casualty and then thus save the casualty life. So next, we'll proceed to the head-to-toe examination. It is also known as secondary survey. So when you are doing the head-to-toe examination, you have to check detailedly from the head to the toe when the casualty is unconscious. So when you exam for the both limbs, so you have to press for the same time in order to check whether there is a presence of the swelling of one of the limb. So when the casualty is conscious, so you can directly ask for the patient, where did the patient feel pain and how is the pain for the patient. So next, we have to take history. Usually the history taking we can do to the casualty and also at the same time for the public around them to ask them what happened during the casualty injury. So when their family is also around, you can also take history from them. Next, I would like to share three real stories that show that first aid is very vital in our real life. So the first one is the golf club. A boy named Ben accompanied his father to the golf club. So the father suddenly collapsed and he has no pulse and breathing. So Ben, which is only 10 years old, he managed to do CPR for his father. Eventually, Ben managed to save his father's life. Luckily, Ben's father taught Ben about the CPR technique during watching a television program. Okay, next, the story I would like to share is that it occurred at the restaurant. a waiter accidentally pour a hot drink onto a baby. Then the sister of the baby immediately take the baby to the toilet to put the burn wound on the under the water for 10 minutes. And this first aid technique also saved the baby's life. So the last story I would like to share is occurred during the rainy day. During a rainy day, when Mary is walking back home, he heard that people shout for help. So he ran to investigate what had happened. She discovered that a very big trunk fell on his neighbor's leg. So Mary put away the branches, and then he used her own hoodie to press on the wound to prevent bleeding. So thus, this helped the neighbor to save his both legs. So the next day, the neighbor give back Mary a